One night in my room, I heard a noise. Since I was awake, I went to the washroom. When I came out, a man crawled out from under my bed. I screamed, ran out, and entered another room. In panic, I urinated on myself.
I was sexually assaulted on a film set over a decade ago. The memory is too painful to recollect. He was a senior person in the industry, and I was just starting out.
We've come down to Kochi, which is in Kerala. It is known for its wonderful food, its diverse culture, and also because it is the hub of the Malayalam film industry. Now, this film industry has been in national headlines for the last many weeks because of something called the Justice Hema Committee Report.
In 2017, a top actress was abducted and sexually assaulted, allegedly on the orders of a famous actor in Kerala. Amidst outrage and protests, the government formed the Justice Hema Committee to investigate the work conditions for women in the industry. It was released 5 years after it was turned in. The report revealed gruesome details like the existence of a casting couch, a mafia of some very powerful men, and how women didn't have access to basic facilities at work.
I once worked in a set which had only 3 women, the female lead, me, and the makeup artist. There were no caravans, no toilets on the set. We would go to the houses nearby and request them to let us use their toilets.
After the actress's assault, a group of women in the industry decided to band together and called themselves the Women in Cinema Collective, or WCC.
Everybody who were concerned about this entire episode came together and said that this is not right. People were very, very much bothered about how safety and security standards are so low that even such a well-known actress may be kind of attacked.
We are going to meet some members of the Women in Cinema Collective. Some people have actually agreed to speak to us on record. That's actually a bit of a challenge in the story because a lot of people are not coming on camera.
Archana Padmini, a member of the WCC, was one of the first to come out with her story of abuse in the film industry under unusual circumstances.
So we had a press meet. It was like a official Women in Cinema Collective press meet. The press then was acting like a crazy mob, male mob. So it was actually a reflex reaction. So there was this production person, who's a production executive. This particular person just attempted to get into this place where I live in, like at night, and was trying to attack. Luckily, I got escaped. I could close the door and I spoke to people, I called people. On next day on set, I reported it to the filmmaker, associate and everyone. Nothing was happening. He was still working there.
So most of the women that we spoke to said that their main problem was that when they had a complaint in the film set or in the industry, they didn't have anyone to take these complaints to. And they were also scared of taking it to the Film Employees Federation of Kerala, or the FEFCA, which is the only trade union body for the film industry in the state.
We asked B. Unnikrishnan, the General Secretary of FEFCA, about these issues. Becoming a member of the FEFCA is considered essential by many to work seamlessly in the industry. And Unnikrishnan has been leading it since 2008.
Strictly speaking, you know, nothing was unfamiliar to me in the report. So we are a trade union and we have our own mechanism. And if an individual member has raised a complaint, first the union addresses it. If they cannot sort it out, we will discuss it at the level of federation. So we have a clear-cut data of how many complaints received in these 16 years, how many of them are sorted out, in what way. So you cannot say that we were not addressing it.
The Hema Committee report also highlighted how women who speak out are often sidelined and find no work. Even when they didn't have ghastly tales to tell, Most women we spoke to said that there was a general sense of misogyny in the industry.
I have that old story of how people kind of overlook your experience, talk above you, try and explain your job back to you. You know, by then I had already been in the business 30 years. I knew what I was doing. I'd been called on to a project that was in crisis. And within 3 months, it became obvious to me that the people involved, or the men involved, were quite thrown by the presence of a woman who knew what she wanted, was very direct in telling them what needed to be done. And I don't think they liked that. And they made it pretty obvious. And so I just thought, I can't possibly work with somebody or with people who will sabotage their own project in a crisis to make a point to a woman. It seems so silly.
We spoke to an art director who had a similar experience to share.
I was doing well and my senior was pleased with my work, which made some men on set jealous. One day I was handed a mop and was told to clean the floor because that's what women do.
Since the report was published, there's been a lot of national attention over how incidents like these could happen in a state like Kerala, which prides itself on its high level of literacy and progressive films.
A group of women coming together to speak up about their rights? Yes, that happens in Kerala. And you're talking about a government that commissions a study committee with three people for studying gender in the film industry? Yes, that happens in Kerala. Are you talking about a report which is prepared and then submitted to the government? Yes, that happens in Kerala. And then finally, when the report is out, people in the industry, outside the industry, everybody is reading it. That happens in Kerala.
With many in the industry saying that the women's outrage is an insult to Malayalam cinema, the women are doubtful if anything will change.
We should have a cinema policy. If needed, specifically to cinema, we should be able to create new laws. There should be some regulatory system from the state or government to just check whether this is happening, or when the conversations are over, everything goes back to the same. We should have this dialogue. State should intervene at this moment. So in that stage, I'm hopeful. But I still think the perpetrators, these people are going to work. They're going to be here. They're going to come back with strength, which I'm not being very pessimistic, but that's the reality.